for Shelley Road. This is Ray. Derkshire Temple. Cummins. Derkshire Horta going to be a Rehistach. Ray Cummins. This is Johnny Leary. Derkshire Skull Hogan. This is Ray Cummins. Now there are 2 points between them. Far more a Derk Sous, as we flahoolish in the road.
On board, go more of a Gary Grave on a stormer, Gravena Chowner.
Shot from out the field, and it's a goal! Ray Cummins, the finisher!
Grave Shea, able to Moran Dina, who to Stachson Emmer.
Right through the centre to Ray Cummins. Ray Cummins now, up and on the wing to Jimmy Barry Murphy.
He Shea, go more able to Concert Kicken or Hogan. In the a Hogan. On command, Agustin Pell, Gunadora Higge, Niflar Nugur, Sar, Atleta.
Ballinock at that time was a very young suburb of Cork City, and the population there generally was young, and so we had plenty of buddies that to play with, you know. There wasn't a green patch in the whole parish that you could play hurling in, you know, or football for that matter. So most of our, you know, activity, I suppose, started in the back garden, but went from there to the road in which we lived, you know. I'm sure we burst plenty of windows, and, you know, as we played on the road, and, you know, of course the pitch was moved up and down the street depending on where we last broke a window. And
there was 2 families in the road that had cars. I remember going to them, would they move the car if there's a match on? And in fairness, they would. They'd shift the car up the top of the road, and the other man would shift the car to the bottom of the road. And Cork would take on Kilkenny, or Cork would take on Tipperary for the next 2 hours. And Tipperary never won, or Kilkenny never won in those matches. But those games on the road were hell for leather. Like, they were as tough as anything in Croke Park, I say.
Does anyone know how many windows we broke?
Huh? The few there. The few there, yeah, right. Yeah.
So Dad was good at repairing glass anyway, that's it.
Yeah.
I make mixed uses.
In particular, there was one individual, a man called Derry Cremin, who was our coach and our mentor and our confidant. And, you know, the amazing thing about Derry was that Derry was paralysed from his hips down and, you know, depended on crutches to get around. But he was the instigator, and he was the motivator for all of us there, you know. As far as I'm concerned, if there's only one saint in heaven, to Derry Cremin, you know.
Remember what Derry Cremin used to say, when he give you a hurley, he giving you a hurley, you stop a swallow going out of the barn door with that noise.
You say that again?
You stop a swallow going out of the barn door with that, he said.
I remember going to a Cork under 15 trial, and there was something like 7 of us from the Black Rock team going for the trial. 6 of the 7 got on the team, on the Cork under 15 team. I was the odd one out, you know. And like I tell this to kids because it's encouragement for kids, because, you know, I was obviously disappointed and obviously resolved to, you know, that I'd go back and work harder at it and you know, make the minor team.
Agus sin aga díreach an rud a hárla. In 1966, Rauníva ar Iren Minúra Chondé, ní maint sin na maint, ach sa bel chamá. Baivi na chaibtín ar na Peladori, agus deirí le hub craobh na mún a ghróchaint. Sa na maint, dí mi ré ar a níine leachúil a glufaig ceannais na héidan a chaliad ar an aileach garmon heis ahimort.
Bíon lom nuair a bhí sé ag imirt le Minúri Corcaí, bhí ochtar an club seo ag imirt leis. Bhí an caidán go Ríomha agus bhí ré a cuisach ma. Ní raibh sé an a loider, ní raibh sé an a chapig, agus is tóch an téanach bhil loider, ní chóir a bhidlic.
Will you mention the fact, Kevin, that the big steaks always gone to punch Ray? Or the 2 eggs? 2 eggs for the breakfast.
You're lucky to have one.
Now, if you could look into school, Katia Gray, is there a whole lot in the whole school of Gork could you ask the question? In the Shaskadi. If you know Grog Shanoid, if you came to the Ninil Torich Tsirhige, if you know Gomor to Shiva Gibun, Agus Vikigur, Kamalashin, if you go to the Rave Illa Aden Grootege, for you've lienis fit the Shagundes na Kumon. Achas mar lea choli, ydi mar shas na lahintasin.
But I was a very average left halfback. If I continue to play in the halfback line, I don't think you'd be talking to me today, you know.
Bhí sé a gcónaí ag gimirt mar lea coolaí. Agus bhí sé cuisach mar, agus is seascané chuas go bhí in America.
We're seconds away from the start of the 1969 All-Ireland Hurling Final.
Nuair a bhí a sáin na fórs lithar ar Mawahar, dúirt sí rom go raibh Ré Gimbert i gcuinne cum an barra, agus go raibh sé go húntach bá, mar lán tosí. Agus capas go raibh darú déanta aici, nár hiip sí an scéal a gart. Agus mí an éag sin hána sa bhaile, agus bhí réigin mar le chorcaig mar lán tosí i bblé ceis na hhéan.
Was in the All-Ireland final in 69. That in itself was traumatic, but you know, I was being marked by Pat Dillon, which was a baptism of fire for any young fella, you know.
Chonic me é I gwine Kilchinnig le Pat Dillon. I guess good ian la sha ni federlum a hiskent conus a varshe an clear fad bisha an dian.
Playing your first All Ireland, you know, first of all, it's a bit of a blur, you know, it passes by very quickly. And I suppose, you know, as a young fellow, you're optimistic that you're, you know, having lost it, you're kind of optimistic that you'll get another chance, you know. And you know, sure enough, we got another chance in 1970.
Paddy Barry's puck out, added to by Charlie Cullinan, to Ray Cummins, Michael Collins with them, but Ray Cummins with it now. A high ball and a point.
And they did shock too. We had Loch Garman a chaile gan Cliffe Canis an Ianach le Corca. Cliffe Epica, agus gur an lú éin chóil déag a láisim.
And now it's Willie Walsh of Cork trying to get a point or maybe a goal, but Pat Nolan blocked it down, it comes back, goal! It's a goal! Willie Walsh with it now, inside the 50-yard line. Into the goal mouth. Out comes Pat Nolan, gets his hand to it, but the ball is sent into the net. Seamus Looney, a high one up there. Well, Captain Bacon's back in the goal. That's Charlie McCarthy. And O'Brien getting it. Eddie down on the 21-yard line. And he deflects the ball in the net, and he says, go on, he is. The goal, a goal there. Another goal by Eddie O'Brien. The final whistle coming any moment. The All-Ireland Senior Hurling Title of 1970 with the score. The final score of Cork, 6 goals and 21 points to Wexford's 5 goals and 10.
It's what you set out at the start of the year and what your teammates set out at the start of the year to try and achieve. And it's just an exceptional experience to win one. So at this stage, I mean, I've been playing with the footballers since 68, and I was now playing both and still under 21. So, you know, it just became hectic after that. It was, you know, game after game and training session after training session. And I recall one particular year that I had one day off and one weekend off in the whole year, and that was the Sunday before Christmas. That's how hectic it was, you know, because this club was very successful, and, you know, that time you had the All-Ireland Club Championship was played through the winter. You had national leagues in the winter. You had club leagues in the winter. And like they just went Sunday after Sunday, and I mean that was supposedly the off season, you know.
Ray Cummins bring the ball down into his hand, the shot, it up and goal! In out to Ray Cummins. Ray, 35 yards out, high, and it's over the bar.
In 1962, Deirdre Le Corca conned a chlore a chloich a glyphicanish na moon. Agus na revidar le aie hwrter na coit a glyphicanish na heiden, bwyd Corca rau na coit iantachta.
Ray Cummins, who has scored two goals
and well ahead of Kilkenny, should never have lost the game, but in fairness to Kilkenny, they came back and beat us. Hugely disappointing, and you know, I still struggle to understand how we lost that game or why we lost that game. You know?
That's 29 points to 26, and so help me God, I hope it's a draw. From the puck out, the ball comes down the field, and it's Pat Delaney, and here comes Pat going way up the field. Tony Marr is after him, but Pat breaks clear, and there's another point for Kilkenny. And there goes the final whistle.
It's a huge disappointment to lose an All-Ireland final, and I've lost a number of them, and I know what it's like.
On tórum a bhíodh coi gíorí ag an am sin, ná dá mbeadh foirn pelle Corcaí go maith, nach mbeadh an sim céanna cos an amáint, agus an rud céanna dá a bhealairt a bhí ann.
Stolm gur orðir innar fadarfad y fi gyda corcw gan wrs yn y siacht awd tri a bydd fwydr sgwnsgan i'r chyri sgwr aldr chwcyn dy foed i y greif na mŵn gyn iddyr sgrisyrin, gyn iddyr sgris cyna agos sgwr aldr na boed i rysht y gyn i hyd ywyn.
Jimmy Barrett coming out for it. Jimmy shot from out the field and it's a goal! Ray Cummins the finisher, Ray Cummins the finisher, one of the overhead specials. Ray Cummins is out there to help the Corkman. Ray takes his shot right across the goal mouth, and it's a goal! It's a goal, Declan Barron! A lovely pass by Ray Cummins.
Agus y chwchy canys, fydd yr ofad eirin eirin rofa dyngailif.
Lo, dag yn crif yn y hen, mwy crif yn y hen y siŵl. Ys cymwyr mae tato dy underdog yn cymwyr ffi. Cahed o'r mach yn lo sy'n, har ein lo oly, agus yn nobyr un, agus yn fel emyrt. Agus yn ffyrin ys fawr, yn lo sy'n y mynd yn bwaco. Agus sy'n y horle, yn lo sy'n.
During the All-Ireland final of 73, our place kicker, Declan Byrne, who was a superb player, had taken a few frees early on in the game, and you know, as can happen to anybody, they weren't going over him. So I was asked to take the frees after that, and you know, and had some reasonable success.
There's the frees, which is going to be taken by Ray Cummins. The 40 yards out, here's the kick. And straight over the bar. Another one for Ray Cummins, the kicker of frees today.
Dóch a gwrdd ar le, mae'r na ffac a gein dyn nhw agos na'r efsie ffisg a gein y rhymysyn rwy y togwn sy'r chic yna. Mae'r ni hawl ofa sy'r chic yna le rwy. Ni fe sy'n yn sort ymwyr o'r e, fi Dennis Colin a'n afachw, fi Dave McCarty a'n afachw. Ach, stoch yn arfer gael i rofa, lewyswn, er y lo, agos gwr er chrawn rwy hitse. Ach, fi'n ein saes dyna, ein dwchlon yn nechon. Fi'n neud y megin ige, fi'n cwmwys ige, fi'n sgil ige.
He's already scored 2 points. Make that three, it's over the bar. 9 players have All-Ireland medals in hurling and in football. Ray Cummins, candidate for number 10 as he comes to take this kick. And there is the angle of the kick. Ray, the sharpshooter, Cummins to take it. And it's over the bar, another point for Ray, his eighth of the game.
My abiding memory, I suppose, was Jimmy Barry Murphy's second goal, 7 minutes from time. Actually, it was Ray put in the long-fisted pass into Jimmy, and Jimmy jinked and stuck it in the net. And that put us 7 points up with 7 minutes to go. So I knew then the All-Ireland was ours.
Our captain, Corky Billy Morgan.
I suppose, even though I'm, you know, fundamentally a hurling person. For me, it was probably one of the most enjoyable All-Irelands from the point of view that it meant so much to people, particularly in West Cork, where football is strong. And the fact that, you know, we'd bridge a gap of something like 48 years since Cork had previously won it.
The great bowl of Fitzgerald Stadium, Killarney, absolutely chock full with the thousands for this monster final between Kerry and Cork.
Because of such euphoria in West Cork, we spent the winter kind of down there celebrating, and I think it came against us in 74, yeah. Even though we again beat Kerry in the monster final, we failed to Dublin in the All-Ireland semi-final.
Is Belgaum Seer of E. Cummins na Blantershin? Pell, Amont, a gear a tacha ho geologus culiorella, Hocrusha Ganidoche, Edin Amont.
Solig Dinagos Nadina Marabin, Faras Varavico, Ediborka, Solig Eva Iamashin Fastigus, Bene Marviga Korskoy, Ach, ni feder here in the Nagar, Kalunt, Damantar Fad, on Bell, a barry.
Cummins gets it in his hands, a great jump, and then he's fouled. That must be a penalty. He's in the large parallelogram.
Heish Gurania, a monhe Horko Walla, a gluffy lech anish in the head in the Shachtu code. Roder crave no moon at east to Shachtu Shea and I Lemino. Villehu Lakum, a horn the Corrie.
He gun pride le on Leonov near of Laden train oil, no V train oil, like near of a lawn train oil, near of Ian Lacrave, so who to Dirachon or Crave the moon, stockly crave the hair. It's kind of like, you know, quick luck arm and so's better shacht for the new machine there, glues the clay. They actually grave luck arm and grave shield couldn't clay a walk into Honey Corky Garage. The rain a captain and Lian Shindar no a shacht o'she, agus captain a rinne a chid chainter in bark, dimmer she mar leach in bark, mar, you know, bull leach carte pel agus a mind.
And Ray Cummins again breaking through. A kick this time and he scored this one.
I suppose it's every young fellow's dream to captain their county. It's a great honour. It probably adds a bit of pressure to your play, if you like, but it's you know, something special.
Half an hour gone in this first half. Oh, a very long tuck out.
Ach, fin captain seo hanana gymru, agus bae for the score cynnwch sa glyffi.
In 76 we were fortunate. We had, you know, obviously had a very good panel of players and we had very good selectors, including Christy Ring, who, to my mind, was probably the shrewdest thinker in the game.
Christy advised the players that this particular referee, whose name escapes me now, would allow you to carry the ball a good few steps. And he advised them all the last night training, go home and stitch pockets into your togs, because this referee will let you travel with the ball.
And I remember getting a ball and turning and passing William Murphy, who was full-back for Wexford. And being about, you know, 20 yards out from goal and knowing that I was going to be hooked, I took more steps than I should have.
I took about 24 steps, I said.
Ringy's kind of words to me before the match kind of stuck in, and only for him I probably would have tried to hit it with the hurley and probably have been blocked down or hooked or whatever, you know.
Christy was right in Cork won.
Cork 27, Wexford 23, and there goes the final whistle, and the All-Ireland champions are Cork.
And Ray was about to come up to get the cup, and I was seated with my parents at the match, and we moved from our seats over towards the presentation area, and the next time I looked around, my father was gone. And he was the man with a heart condition, and he had been advised some years earlier that he shouldn't attend any match. But the next time I looked around, he was gone, and then I saw him out in the field, and he under Ray. He was trying to lift Ray to bring him off the field after winning the All-Ireland. I thought that was just an emotional moment at the time, you know. The man that had lived hurling all his life and now seeing his son captain of the Cork team. How would life have been for him without hurling?
Nimmer on Laura Gumsa, Aquil, Fear Osaring, Kernsha, Kern McCarrig, a Glockaharnash Corkig.
On Vlian Dargian, Vidar Aresha Borka Kroka, Gun Lawmore and Mimian Fulford. It was in Yenogla Hobbit East, Loch Garamond.
Do we think we're going to win it again? I suppose we set out with the same ambition as we had before that.
Again, it was very tight, and I remember Martin Poe making a great save towards the end of that game, and we were very lucky. If it went in, Wexford could have won the game.
If you remember Trace Boch into our Loch Garman Shacht, or Shea, Shacht, or Shacht, it's like a knowed cart to be on a shacht or hocht on star cart and clay cart, Kiel Queenix of Crave, three in a row. Agus, it's like, you know, we shade their gawk on the mag, good in shacht no hocht no made dernot nor for Jimmy Barry and the cool.
I don't think in 78 that, you know, we were particularly motivated by to win three in a row. I think, you know, we just took each match as it came. But certainly when it got to the All-Ireland final and, you know, I suppose there's great rivalry always between Cork and Kilkenny, and that was an added incentive, if you like, probably even more so than winning the three in a row, you know.
It's clean them first, like, you know, we Ray in the Lakes of Clashin, or Fui Shea Law on the road, you Rinne Shea and Rod Cart, Fur Shea, Anna Coolin on Tave Clay, Stochig, Darren Clay, and Kerra Coolin, and Curry on the four niggas. Mara Rinne in Salon Clahee.
Paddy Prendergast, complete now by Ray Cummins. And there's the insurance point. That's a point for Ray Cummins, putting Cork now 3 points ahead again. 35, almost 36 minutes gone. Cork, although the whistle hasn't gone, are the champions. They must be the champions. Their bench waiting to run in to cheer and chair them. The referee running for the ball, and Cork for the All-Ireland champions. And there's the trophy. Well, it's nice to have that, but to have in the record book that you've won another All-Ireland, and that you've beaten Kilkenny in doing so, that you've won three in a row, that's even more important than having the McCarthy Cup.
Níl Seansar Domhan ann. Go me up three favourite as a heel, Boite, Corkig, and Orshin, Akaroan, Grev, Ray, Mar, Winna, Larnock, then Natosaha, Vian, Eganown.
Having won the three in a row, you know, 79 was no different. I mean, you just took each game as it came. And again, we fell to Galway in the All Ireland semi final. And again, you know, on the day, the better team won. And we had no qualms about it, you know. 82 was my last year, and you know, we got to the All-Ireland final playing Kilkenny. I was marked that day by a young Brian Cody, and you know, towards the end of the game, I recall having to chase Brian practically the full length of Croke Park, you know. Some people say I didn't get back until the game was over.
I say Ray will be remembered as a great player, great sportsman. Great clubman, great intercounty player, great captain.
Imrod and Scott have been on, like, Bhíodh sé agus deas Ray Cummins agus Joe Dean agus Brian Corcoran a bheith mar lína lántasach agat.
Nuair a bheith brehónas a thuairt ag deire ar Ray. Go nglach ag gach éin a leis. Gorb imróir íntach é. Agus gorb lántasach din sco é. Agus béidir nach mbeidh éine chomh maith leis.
You know, I had no regrets.